Today we will start the remaining two operation of algebra, multiplication and division. That I told you in my previous lecture that Al-Khwarizmi was the father of algebra and he invented the algebra. Why we use algebra? Because most of our word problem, unknown elements, we find unknown elements from the algebra, and this is the relation with arithmetics and algebraic expression. Yesterday we learned all the expressions, algebraic expression, constant, variables, polynomials, types of polynomials, addition and subtraction of the algebraic expression. Now we will start from the multiplication, and again I advise you that you must be careful about the power and signs of the algebraic expression. If you know the tricks of the multiplication, the signs, the power, algebra will be very, very easy for you. Okay girls, first the multiplication of polynomial. We have the rule of polynomial of multiplication. The product of two polynomials is also a polynomial, definitely. When we add two polynomials, our answer is n polynomial. When we subtract the polynomials, again we got an other polynomial. Same in the product. When we multiply two polynomials, our answer will become the polynomial, a new polynomial. But what will be the difference between these two polynomials whose degree is equal to the sum of the degrees of two polynomials? It means that when we multiply the two polynomials, what happened? The power of the variable, we add them. So that's why here they mentioned that the degree is equal to the sum of the degrees of two polynomials. If the power of the variable in first polynomial is square and the other polynomial is 1, then after the multiplication we got the highest degree of the polynomial is q, because 2 plus 1 is 3. From the example, this will be clear to you. These are two rules of multiplication. When you multiply two polynomials, you should keep in mind these two rules. When both polynomials have negative sign, I also told you in addition and subtraction, when we have two positive sign in addition, when we have two positive sign, we add the numbers and the sign will be positive. When we have one negative sign and one positive sign, we add them and we use the sign of the greater number. But we always subtract them. Same when we have two minus sign, we add them and we use the negative sign. Now we have the rules of multiplication. They are totally different from the addition. In addition, only we add the coefficients, not the power. But in multiplication, we multiply the coefficients and as well as the power of the variable. When both polynomials have negative sign, in answer we use positive sign. This is totally opposite in addition. When we have two negative sign, we add them and we use a sign of negative. And the power of the variable increase if both variables are same. Same means when you multiply x with x or x with y with y, z with z, then the power of the variable will be changed. Minus 5x, minus 10x. When we multiply them, we got 50x square. The power of the x will be 2. If we have different variables mean x and y, they both are different, then we multiply the coefficient only and also the sign. But we cannot add the powers. Minus 3x, minus 5y, 15, minus, minus, plus, plus 15xy, because both variables are changed. In the above example, there is 50x square. I think square is left by me. but there is 50x square. Okay, when you are doing the question, you must add the powers of the variable. Yes, rule number two, if both signs are opposite in our answer, the answer will be negative. It means when we have one positive number and one negative number, then the answer will be negative. Minus 6x and plus 4x. You multiply, you got minus 24x square. You see that in this example, I write there the square. I put the square over there. Because x and x, when we multiply, the power add. Coefficient multiply 6 with 4, 24, and also the sign multiplied. Minus with plus, it become minus. Minus 24x square. And the next, now you see that both variables are changed, x and y. Again, you multiply the coefficients, 2 with 3, the opposite sign, minus and plus. So the answer, the sign of the answer will be negative. And 6xy, no change in the power of the variable because both variables are changed. Yes, now come to the question. Find the product of the following polynomials. There are three part and this is a question 6 of exercise 5.2. I done first part for you and you remember that the same questions, same type of the questions we have done in class 7. Find the product of two polynomials x plus 3 x square minus 3x plus 9. Again, I tell you that what is polynomial in which the degree of the variable is positive or zero. Now, x plus 3, the degree of or the power of the x is positive. Also in the next bracket, x square minus 3x, both powers are positive. So they both are polynomials. When we start to multiply these two, first, we multiply x with the next polynomial, the whole one, x square minus 3x plus 9, as you can see on the screen. And then the term of plus 3. Then we multiply plus 3 with x square minus 3x plus 9. First, we multiply x with the next polynomial. Then there is positive sign, so we put plus 3 there. And we multiply it with x square minus 3x plus 9. Come to the first bracket. We are multiplying x with x square. I told you that in multiplication, what we did, we add the power of same variable. Now both x are same. First x has power 1 and the second 2. 1 plus 2, 3. The answer will be x 3. The next term is minus 3x. When you multiply minus 3x with x, the power of x will be 2 because the both x have 1 power. 1 plus 1, 2. Now is the turn of the constant term 9. There is no variable. So we directly write 9x. The multiplication of the first bracket complete. Now come to the second one. There is only 3, no variable with 3. So we directly multiply each term with 3. 3x square minus 3 times 3, 9. 3 nines are 27. No change in the power of the variable in second bracket because only 3 multiplied with that bracket. And all the powers of the first bracket change because we are multiplying it with x. And in the multiplication, I told you what happened. The power of the variable always increase. X cube minus 3x square plus 9x plus 3x square minus 9x plus 27. Now we equate the like terms. Equating like terms. The highest power is 3. So we write first x cube, then the power of x square minus 3x square plus 3x square. Plus 9x, then minus 9x, and at the end we write constant. Only one constant we have, 27. When we subtract 3 and 3, here we use the rule of addition. When we have two opposite signs, what happened? The answer will become 0 or both term will be cancelled. minus 3 plus 3, one is positive, other is negative, we subtract it. So it becomes 0 again, plus 9x and minus x, minus 9x, we subtract it, 0. X cube plus 27, no need to mention here, the sum of these two terms becomes 0 because we already cancelled the terms in the previous step. Our answer is x cube plus 27. Clear? The same two, you have to do the same two parts on the same pattern. Don't you worry that there are three terms. You have already done these type of question in class 7. Now we have question 7 in our exercise. If P, Q and R. Now three polynomials are given and they name the polynomial as P, Q and R. Then find P, Q, Q, R, P, R and P, Q, R. P, Q means you will find the product. You multiply P with Q. Q, R means you multiply Q with R. P, R means you multiply P with R. And P, Q, R means we multiply P with Q and then after finding the answer, we multiply it with R. I did the last part for you, P, Q, R, because this is the biggest one. To finding P, Q, R, first we find P, Q and then we multiply it with R. The value of P in the question is given x square minus yz. And Q is given y square minus xz. You see on the left hand side, I write PQ and the right hand side, instead of them, I write the value of P and Q. Now we multiply x square with y square minus xz and then minus yz with the same polynomial y square minus xz. First, in the first bracket, x square multiplied by y square. We cannot add the powers because both variables are changed. So we write there x square, y square only. The next term, xz. Xz and we multiply xz with x square. Before the bracket, there is square. And inside the bracket, there is 1x. 2 plus 1, x3. You see that I change the power of the x, but the power of the z is same. Only we change the power of the variable x. Finish. Now come to the second bracket. Minus yz. Minus yz. We did in question 4. When there is a negative sign and also in question 2, if there is a negative sign before the bracket, when you open the bracket, all the sign of that bracket will be changed. Yes, we done this in question 2. Subtract P from Q. Okay, now we multiply minus yz with y square. Outside the bracket, there is 1y and inside the bracket, y square. When we multiply it, we add only the power of y. The power of z will be unchanged when you multiply it with y square. Y square into y. This becomes y cube. And z will be there. Then the next term, inside and outside the bracket, both have the negative sign. So minus, minus, plus. That I told you before this. In the definition of the multiplication and the rule of the multiplication, when we multiply two negative sign in the answer, we put there plus. So minus, minus, plus. Now x, y, they both are different variable, but we have z outside the bracket and also inside the bracket. Z. And you see that only the power of z changed, it becomes z squared. So after multiplying both the polynomials P and Q, we got x square y square minus x3z minus y3z plus xyz square. No like term is there, so no need to write equating like terms. Now is the turn of multiplication with R. We multiply PQ with R, the new polynomial that we find after the multiplication. Now we multiply this with R. The answer of PQ is x square y square minus x cube z minus y cube z plus xyz square. We multiply this relation with z square minus xy. Z square minus xy. See, in the first bracket, the first term is x square y square. We multiply this with z square minus xy. Then the next term is minus x cube z. Then again z square minus xy. Then next minus y cube z. Again z square minus xy. And the last term is xyz square with z square minus xy. It means every term of the first bracket will be multiplied with the second bracket, second polynomial, which is the value of R. Come to x square y square, the first bracket, x square y square z square. All the variables are different, so we write x square y square z square. No change in the power of x, y and z. When we multiply x, y with x square y square, now the both the power of the variable will be changed. 3x, x3 and y3. The sign will be same. Minus, because x square y square having positive sign. Come to the next bracket. X cube z and z square, but the sign is negative. So it means that the sign will be changed inside the bracket. X cube, there are 3z. 2z inside the bracket and 1z outside the bracket. Z cube. Then the positive sign. I told you that there is negative sign, so the sign of the bracket will be changed. Plus, now how many x are there? 4. 3 outside the bracket and 1 inside the bracket. And then yz. Come to the third one. Same y cube. There are 2z. Z square is inside and 1z is outside. It becomes z cube. The sign, instead of minus, it will be plus. Then x, y and y 3z. Only the sign of the power of the y will be changed. X, y, 4z. Then the last bracket, y, z, 4, because 2z outside and 2z inside the bracket. The power of z becomes z, 4 minus x square, y square, z square. X square, y square and z square. After the multiplication of these two polynomials, we got x square y square z square minus x cube y cube minus x cube z cube plus x4 yz minus y cube z cube plus xy4z plus xyz4 minus x square y square z square. Now again equating like terms, because there are two terms are alike, x square, y square and z square. When we rearrange the term, you see that because both x square, y square, z square have the opposite sign, so we cancel them. And the remaining terms, minus x cube, y cube, minus x cube, z cube, minus y cube, z cube. These three terms are cube. So we enclose them within one bracket and we took the negative sign common. The next three terms, x4, yz, xy, 4z, xy, z4, xy, z, xy, z, xy, z. This is common in all these three terms. So we took x, y, z common and the remaining numbers, x cube, z cube and y cube. They left within the bracket. So after multiplication, our answer is x, y, z into x cube plus z cube plus y cube minus x cube y cube plus x cube z cube plus y cube z cube. I hope that it will be clear to you. Yes, our next question is about division. You know that division is the opposite operation of multiplication. In this, only we subtract the coefficients. No change in the power. Now we add the terms, not we subtract the powers, only the coefficient of the variables will be subtract, because you know in the division of the number also we subtract the terms. Division of polynomial, if a polynomial is exactly divisible by another polynomial, then the remainder is zero. Definitely in the same number that when we divide, suppose we are dividing 35 with 7, 7 5 times 35 and the remainder will be 0. Same in the polynomials, when we divide two polynomials and they are exactly divisible by each other, our remainder should be equal to 0. We have four questions of division in our exercise. Question number 8 and 8 have 6 parts, and then 9, 10 and 11. Simplify, and you see in each part they write there the division sign. I did part 4 for you. X cube plus x square minus 14x minus 24 divided by x plus 2. This is new topic for you, so you should be careful. X cube plus x square, we always put the highest degree polynomial inside the division sign. And after the division, the polynomial we write there, x plus 2. X cube plus x square minus 14x minus 24. You always see the first term of both the polynomial. The first term is x cube, and x plus 2, the first term is x. To make x into x cube, we need 2x. I mean the power of x will be 2. And you see in the rough work, I did the multiplication for you. X plus 2, you multiply it with x square. When you multiply x square with x, we got x cube. Again, we multiply x square with 2, we got 2x square. We got 2x square. When you multiply x plus 2 with x square, the first term will become x cube and the other term become 2x square. Again, I miss here the square, but you see in the question, I put there square on x. Yes, we write x cube under the x cube and 2x square under the x square. According to the division rule, we change the sign. Plus change into minus and minus change into plus. Both signs are positive. So you see there, I write plus minus. the negative sign under the plus, it means we change this sign. We change plus into minus. X cube and x cube, they both cancel with each other. Plus x square and minus 2x square. One term is plus and other is minus. It means we subtract the terms. 2 minus 1 will be 1. Minus x square and minus 14x. Minus 24. Again, minus x square. I told you that only you concentrate on the first term. Leave the other terms 14x and minus 24. Only you concentrate on the minus x square. We need minus sign and we need 1x, because 1x is given in the question. X plus 2. 1x, we have 1x. To make x in x square, we need only 1x. You see here, x plus 2 and I multiply it with minus x. In the second rough work, you see in the second step, x plus 2 and we multiply it with minus x. When x and x multiplied, we got x square, which is our required first term. And the other term will be minus 2x. So under x square, you write the x square, and under x, you put minus 2x. Again, according to the rule of division, we change the sign. Minus change into plus, and again minus change into plus. X square and x square cancelled. Now you have minus 14x and plus 2x. Minus 14x and plus 2x. One is positive, other is negative. We subtract both terms. We subtract both terms. 14 minus 2 is 12, but we use the sign of minus because the greater number is 14. Minus 12x minus 24. And now we have the last step in which we will find minus 12x. We have already x. X plus 2, we have x. Only we need what? Minus 12. Only we need the coefficient of x. Minus 12. And you see in the third step, I multiply x plus 2 with minus 12. Minus 12x minus 24. When you multiply minus 12 with x, we got minus 12x. And when you multiply with 2, minus 24. Now we write x under the x and 24 under the 24. Change the sign and both terms will be cancelled and remainder become 0. And our quotient is x square minus x minus 12. As you see in the rough work, all the terms we write instead of the constant. First term we multiply first time with x square, then we multiply with minus x, and then we multiply it with minus 12. Students, division little bit difficult for you because this is new topic for you. So you will see the video again and again and try to do the question. I don't say that you can do the question the first time. You can do again and again. You have the mistake, but inshallah after two or three times doing the question, you understand this. Yes, come to the question 9. What should be added to this so that it becomes exactly divisible by this? Exactly divisible by this. It means that in the question, the divisor and the dividend which are given to us, this is not exactly divisible by 2x plus 1. According to the definition, in the division, both polynomial, if they have the remainder 0, it means that they are exactly divisible by each other. But in this question, they already mentioned that they are not exactly divisible by each other. It means that we have some remainder over there. After doing the division, we see that we have the remainder over there, which number will be in the remainder. Same 4x cubed minus 10x squared plus 12x plus 6. And we divide it by 2x plus 1. Again, you concentrate only the first term of the dividend and also the divisor. 4x cubed and 2x. Only see these two. 4x cubed. To make 2x as a 4x cube, how many x we need? 2x. X square and the coefficient 2. You see in the rough work, 2x plus 1, we multiply it with 2x square. We got 4x cube plus 2x square. We multiply 2x square with 2x and then 2x square with 1. 4x cube plus 2x square. So under the x cube, you will write that term, and under the x square, you will write the term of the x square. You see that we change the sign according to the division rule. When we change the sign, the first term will be cancelled. Minus 10x square and minus 2x square. There will be minus 12x square. Minus 12x square plus 12x plus 6. Now again, concentrate only the first term, which is minus 12x square. And to the other side, we have 2x. To make 2x as a minus 12x square, what we did? We multiply 2 with 6 because 2 times 6 is 12. And how many x we need? Only 1x. You see in the rough work, I multiplied 2x plus 1 with minus 6x. Minus 12x square, minus 6x. Now under the x square, we put the term of the x square, and under the x, we write there x. According to the rule, again, we change the sign. X square will be cancelled. And what will be left? Plus 12x and plus 6x. 18x plus 6. Now again, concentrate only the first term. 18x. 18x and 2x. 18x and 2x. In both, we have the x, so no need to multiply it with x. Only we multiply it with any number. We multiply 2 with 9 because 9 2 times 18. We multiply 2x plus 1 with 9, 18x plus 9. You see in the rough column, 18x plus 9. we put 18x under the 18x and 9 under the 6. 18x, when we change the sign, it will be cancelled. Now remainder is minus 3. Because in the question, it is mentioned that they are not exactly divisible by each other. So from the question, we understand that there must be some remainder. Minus 3 is left. Plus 3 should be added. So when you got the minus 3, you always put the opposite sign. If there is plus 3, it means that we add minus 3. The answer is minus 3. So we write plus 3 should be added to the given expression so that it become exactly divisible by 2x plus 1. Clear? Come to the 10 question. Question number 10. The product of two polynomials is this. If one polynomial, then find the other polynomial. This type of the question is given in the previous question when given that the sum of two polynomial is this. One polynomial is given, find the other. But here is a product and there is a sum. And what we did? We subtract. We take the opposite operation of addition. Here we take the opposite operation of product. Product means multiplication. And the opposite operation of multiplication is division. So definitely you divide both the polynomials, but always remember that we put the highest degree inside the division sign. 6y cube minus 11y square plus 6y minus 1. And we divide it by 3y square minus 4y plus 1. And I do all the rough work for you. Again, you concentrate the first term, only 6y cube, and there 3y square. Only we see 6y cube and 3y square. We multiply 3 with 2 to got 6, and y to make y square as a y cube. 3y square minus 4y plus 1, we multiply it with 2y. 6y cube minus 8y square plus 2y, because 2y first multiply with 3y square, then 4y, then 1. We write the numbers under the cube, square and y. First term will be cancelled. Minus 3y square plus 4y minus 1 is left. Now we multiply only with minus 1 and we got our required answer. We change the sign according to the rule of the division and we got the second polynomial, which is 2y minus 1. Here's the last question. For what value of p? This is same that we did question 9. Only here the variable is given. On question 9, constant is given, and in question 11, p is given. For what value of p, the polynomial, this becomes exactly divisible by x minus 3. Again, we put 3x cubed minus 7x squared minus 9x plus p, and we divide it with x minus 3. Concentrate the first term, which is 3x cubed, and there x. To make x as a 3x cubed, we need 3 and 2x. We multiply x minus 3 with 3x squared. 3x cubed minus, when we multiply 3 with 3x square, minus 9x square. Again, we put the value x cube under the x cube, x square under the x square. X cube will be cancelled when we change the sign, and 2x square will be left. 2x square minus 9x plus b. Again, see 2x square and there x. To make x as a 2x square, we multiply it with 2x. The sign of the 2x square is positive, so also we put there the positive sign. 2x with x, 2x square, 2x with minus 3, minus 6x. And we got minus 3x plus p. Again, the first term is minus 3x and we have there x. We already have x, so no need multiply with x, only we multiply it with minus 3. Minus 3x and 3 times 3 is 9 plus 9. Now I put the values, x will be cancelled, p will be left and 9 will be left. So we must write the equation. The polynomial is exactly divisible by each other. The remainder should be equal to 0. So we write p minus 9 is equal to 0. and the value of p will become 9. Clear? Students, I hope that division of the polynomials will be clear to you, and you must do this again and again. Now your homework, exercise 5.2. Question number 6, part 2 and 3, because I done part 1 for you. And question number 8, the remaining parts. There are 6 parts in question 8. I done 1 for you. The remaining 5 parts is your homework. Okay, student, inshallah, the next meeting we will start chapter number 6. And I hope that all the topics of 5.1 and 5.2 is clear to you. If you have any problem, you can ask to me. Thank you very much. Okay, students, Allah Hafiz.